Have you ever wondered what kind of life exists in the depths of the ocean? Kind of like what might exist in outer space? Are there animals living in the ocean that we've never even seen before? Do they stay put, living around the same coral reef, or are they on the move, traveling far distances? How has their habitat changed over time? So much of the ocean is still unexplored, and there's a lot to learn. My name is Megan Deehan, and as a marine conservation student at the University of Miami's Rosenstiel School of Marine and Atmospheric Science, I'm interested in learning how scientists monitor marine ecosystems to answer those questions. I did some reading and came across the concept of environmental DNA, or eDNA sampling. I wanted to learn more, so I decided to travel far and wide in search of experts doing the latest research with eDNA. My epic journey took me just across the street to NOAA's Atlantic Oceanographic and Meteorological Laboratory, where I spoke to marine scientist Nathan Formel.
Hi, my name is Nate Formel. I'm a researcher at NOAA's Atlantic Oceanographic and Meteorological Lab in Miami. Traditionally, people go out into the field, which could be anywhere. It could be a river, it could be a lake, it could be the ocean. And they go and look at what animals are out there. Some animals are shy and they're not easy to find, so another way to look for them is by catch surveys, where fishermen or scientists go out and go fishing or go trawling, and they try to collect the animals in an environment to understand what's there. But another more advanced way to do it is through eDNA, or environmental DNA. eDNA is environmental DNA. It's anything that came off of an animal, which could be its skin, it could be its boogers, it could be its mucus, it could be its scales, its poop.
Hold on. Did he say poop? So could I use eDNA to figure out which neighbor's dog is going to the bathroom in our lawn? Interesting.
And an eDNA sample is just water that you collect from a place, you filter it, and those little particulates of all the animals in that area are in your sample. And that's how you identify what's there. You might not see it, but you can detect it in its environment. And because a little bit of that animal's DNA is mixed in with all those particulates, we can actually analyze them back in the lab and find out if they were there when we went to sample. eDNA can do that. eDNA can be used to quantify presence and population size, at least compared to other animals in the area. So eDNA is a great way to find animals that are really important to notice, but maybe more difficult to sight.
Tune into our next video to learn about new technology developed at NOAA's Atlantic Oceanographic and Meteorological Laboratory, used to do underwater automated samples of environmental DNA, or eDNA. It's going to be sassy. You don't want to miss it.